The next general elections, due next year, promises to be fought vigorously. So far, the UDC has won a series of by-elections. The question now remains whether they could continue with this trend going forward. As usual, I'm joined by Spencer Mohapi, the deputy editor of the Sunday Standard, to discuss this issue of by-elections, also to speak on the next general elections that are due. Afternoon, Spencer.
Hello.
Alright. What's your take on the victory that the UDC has been doing over the past few months?
Obviously, the UDC, when it comes to by-elections, they have been performing quite well in almost all of them, I would say. But look, the by-elections on their own, they are never a very accurate barometer to measure the performance during the coming elections. They are within their right, I think, as the UDC, to continue celebrating. And the hope, I think, amongst themselves is that this trend would continue up until the general elections. But there are issues, I think, within the UDC that really need to be addressed if they are to take state power, because that is their stated ambition. What they need to do is to bring in a bit of stability within their project, and that has been lacking. They have been fighting amongst themselves for constituencies. People are not very happy with the top leadership. I know that the Botswana Congress Party, which is the latest to join, has not been very, very happy with the Botswana Movement for Democracy, that the party has been given too much in as far as the number of constituencies for their own size and contribution to the project. So the question, of course, is how will, in the immediate future, will they be able to handle these differences? I think so far it has not been encouraging as far as the leadership commitment to resolve the differences within the UDC. The party seems to be, the leaders are running away from resolving the issues. Rather than face these difficulties head on, it would seem to me that they think that the problems will on their own resolve themselves or just disappear. It won't happen. But you must also face the reality that the Botswana Democratic Party, since the arrival of Masisi, they are somewhat really buoyant, and he seems to be well awake, that is Masisi, also to what he needs to do and correct to get the people back on the side of the BDP. So there are many problems inside the UDC, notwithstanding the many victories of by-elections they've had.
Okay, but the detractors of UDC, they classified the party as unstable. Yet we saw them winning two consecutive by-elections.
Yes.
Why do you think people still go and vote for a party that is believed to be unstable?
In all the by-elections you are talking about, there are traditional strongholds, especially of the Botswana National Front. And we must also not remember the way our elections in this country are based. They are constituency based. Just to win two by-elections, the English would say one swallow does not make a summer. To win the state power, you need to win a string of more than around 26 constituencies. They've just been winning maybe one constituency and a few council seats. That cannot be the accurate, like I said, barometer for measuring their performance next year at the general elections. Why? Because, like I'm saying, all those areas they've been winning, they've always been their strongholds, save for the Francistown East by-election that they won. And we must give credit to them on this one, that they took it from the Botswana Democratic Party for the first time since the country got independence. That is really very good. If they continue like that, yes, but there are many internal issues, structural differences internally that they have to resolve as the UDC, for people to start believing again that they are really within reach of state power. Because the people who are now voting these by-elections, they are the people who registered in 2014. There are a lot of people that would be registering for the first time in for the elections next year. Is the party able to attract those people, especially the young people, under the current unstable situation? I'm worried that may not be the case.
So are you saying time could not be on the side of the UDC?
Not at all. That's exactly what I'm saying. I'm saying time is not on the side of the UDC. You'd also recall that the Botswana Democratic Party has already held primary elections for all constituencies that are currently held by the opposition. All of them. But not so with many parties that make up the UDC. They are still to call their primaries. Primaries by nature call instability within any party. So there are so many hurdles that the UDC is going to have to cross before the 2019 general elections. For the BDP, they are now grappling with the differences as a result of the recent past by-elections for those constituencies held by opposition, and they are resolving their differences. We will see how the UDC itself, when it times comes for its own primaries, that will be able to perform in as far as conflict resolution internally.
Okay, but there's a factor of the AP coming into space also. How much of a role is the AP going to play in terms of the outcome for the opposition in general?
No doubt the AP is going to be a factor, especially if they continue to be steadfast in refusing to join the UDC. They may split the opposition vote. They may strengthen the resolve of the Botswana Democratic Party. And certainly, it is possible that the AP itself might win a few council wards and some constituencies. And the likelihood is that they will be taking those from the UDC more than from the Botswana Democratic Party.
Okay. And then there's an issue of voter apathy in Motshwedi East, for instance. We realize that a lot of people didn't turn out to elections. Does that speak to what could be the issue of people now losing interest on national issues as a result of what is going on in various political parties, both at the ruling and the opposition parties?
The voter apathy is a big national issue. It's likely to come back full force next year. And I think if it happens, as we fear it will, we should really blame the UDC because they failed to live up to the momentum that they created post-2014. People are no longer expecting that this party is the one that will take power from the BDP. And that might result in people simply moving away from voting at all.
Okay. So as we close, I want you to speak on what the opposition need to do as a bloc to ensure that they reverse the gain that President Masisi and the BDP seems to be making so far. I know some people see it as artificial, but it could go either way. So, but there's need for certain action by the opposition as a bloc.
The immediate issue for the opposition is to resolve their internal differences. The second issue is that they must take themselves seriously and present themselves as a real contender and an alternative to the BDP. So far, they have not reached that threshold yet.
As usual, this is just one of the topics that we feel you should be able to discuss at home. As noted, the IEC is expected to hold the first registration in September 2018. For now, let's thank Mohapi for coming through. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.